Hi friends, I am Arun Giri. You are most welcome to our channel Technical Concept. So our today's topic is airlock and its function in pharmaceutical industry. So in this video we will see what is airlock and what are the applications of airlock and how it is working and what are the different types of airlocks. Okay, so let's start our video without wasting the time. So first of all, see what is airlock. So airlock is a small compartment. It is made in pharmaceutical industry for avoiding cross contamination of products manufactured in the pharma industry. Okay, and it is used for maintaining the cleanliness of the clean room. Okay, so now we'll see what are the different types of airlocks are there. So airlocks are of mainly three types. First is cascade airlock, and second is bubble airlock, and third is sink airlock. Now we will see all three in detail one by one. So first of all, we will see cascade airlock. So cascade airlock diagram of cascade airlock has shown here. Cascade airlock has less pressure as compared to corridor pressure, and it has more pressure as compared to cubicle. Here cubicle is nothing but the manufacturing area where drugs are or medicines are manufactured. Okay, so here 3 plus indicates higher pressure, here 2 plus indicates this airlock has less pressure as compared to corridor, and here 1 plus is given. That means this airlock has more pressure as compared to cubicle. That means air will flow from corridor to airlock and from airlock to cubicle. Okay, so we are doing like this to avoid the contamination of this powder or particle generated in this cubicle to come out from this room and mix with this air of corridor. Okay, if this particles comes in corridor and mix with the air of corridor, then what happens? This air, contaminated air, can go in other areas where other drugs or medicines are manufactured and mix with that air and contaminate the product of that area. Okay, to avoid this, we are keeping maximum pressure in corridor and minimum in cubicle, so that air will flow from corridor to airlock and from airlock to cubicle. So by this way, it cleanliness of this area maintained very well. Okay, it is mostly used in tablet manufacturing area. Okay, because in tablet manufacturing area only we are generating the powders. Okay, so it is mostly used in tablet and capsule manufacturing area. Now second is bubble airlock. Okay, the bubble diagram of bubble airlock shown here. Bubble airlock has maximum pressure than its surrounding areas like corridor and cubicle. Here corridor is indicated by a single plus, and here airlock indicated by a double plus. That means that airlock has maximum more pressure than the corridor and cubicle. Suppose airlock has a 30 pascal pressure, then corridor will have 15 pascal pressure and cubicle will have 15 pascal pressure. Okay, this type of airlock is mostly used in injectable plants. Okay, in injectable plants there is less chances of cross contamination because there is no particles generated in injectable plants, but there is a high chances of biological contamination. So to avoid biological contamination, this airlock has maximum pressure and avoiding the coming of corridor air into the cubicle air, because in corridor there is a high man movement. Okay, so humans are generating more biological germs. Okay, to avoid coming this biological germs in this cubicle area, injectable manufacturing area, this airlock are kept at higher pressure than the corridor and cubicle, so that air will flow from corridor to airlock to corridor and from airlock to cubicle, and these two areas were separated from each other. Okay, so like this way this bubble airlock working. Now third one is a sink airlock. Okay, so in sink airlock has minimum less pressure as compared to its surrounding areas like corridor and cubicle. Here cubicle is indicated by 2 plus and airlock is indicated by 1 plus. That means here airlock has less pressure as compared to cubicle and here corridor. Okay, suppose airlock has 15 Pascal pressure, then cubicle will have 30 Pascal pressure and corridor will also have 30 Pascal pressure. Okay, this type of airlock mostly used in areas where harmful substances are manufactured, like poisons and other harmful products, medicinal products are produced in this area. In this area, this zinc airlock is mostly used. Okay, so this is all about the today's topic. I hope you understood the concept of airlock and its function. So if you like the video, then please press the like button and subscribe the channel, and also share this video. While subscribing, also press the bell icon so that you will get all the notification of my videos. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.